At the end of March 2015, a Soyuz capsule will launch with three astronauts on board, two of whom, the American Scott Kelly and the Russian Mikhail Kornienko, will be embarking on the first joint international one-year mission on the space station. This mission will really kick off the international approach to biomedical research on the International Space Station in terms of having joint investigations between the U.S. and the Russians in a way that hasn't been done in decades, and also involving the Europeans and the Japanese and the Canadians in some of these investigations for truly international data collection on the space station. We have a set of investigations that which fit into different groupings. There's the functional group, which looks at performance of the astronauts. There's the visual impairment group, tracking the effects of long-duration spaceflight on ocular health. There's the behavioral health group, which looks at the psychological, psychosocial aspects of long-duration spaceflight. There's a metabolic group, which looks at the effects of spaceflight on your blood-borne chemistries and your immune system. There's the physical performance group, which really looks at the effects of spaceflight on exercise capability and tests the validity of certain countermeasures. We have microbial investigations, looking at the microbiome, the microbial organisms that live inside each and every one of us. And there's the human factors kinds of investigations, which deal with how the astronauts relate to the environment around them. All of that is important information to have as we start designing space vehicles for long-duration flights beyond low Earth orbit off to Mars. This one-year expedition represents a focused effort to reach across national and technological boundaries and make the space station truly an international space station.